lot of backs, but we have help. Josh Zumstein is a chiropractor at the Back Safety Wellness Center in Homewood, and he is the author of Secrets Up to Preventing Back and Neck Pain. He's here to share six ways to a pain-free back, and a former WGN Morning News intern. It's good to see you get out of the broadcasting business to do something with your life.
It is great to be back, Larry. I love it here.
Welcome back. Tip number one, don't sleep on your stomach. I used to always do this. Why is that bad?
So stomach sleeping basically decreases the natural curves in your spine. It's probably the number one way that most patients have back pain when they sleep. So instead of sleeping on your stomach, you want to sleep on either your back or your side.
Okay. And our second tip is, I think people with a bad back, they think firm mattress. You say that's too much.
Right, so there are two research studies that each independently validated the other study, and they found that sleeping on what's called a medium firm mattress is more effective for reducing back pain.
Okay. And this one, you know, I think we all know, but we never do, it's sit with lower back against the chair, because I'm always kind of sitting, you know, like this. You know, you're working, but not good.
Well, not so much, not unless you want to have back pain, which would be defeating the purpose of this talk here. So something that you can remember is what we call the rule of 90.
Yeah.
So when you're sitting, you want to keep your torso and your hips at a 90-degree angle.
Mm-hmm.
Then you want to keep your knees also at a 90-degree angle, too.
Okay. And the same for driving as well, which I guess I don't even think about. I like to kind of be comfortable when I'm driving.
And it's sometimes a little harder to sit with that perfect posture when you drive, which is why what you're sitting on now can help assist in that process, which is an accessory lumbar support.
And what about that headrest in the car? My head never seems to rest on that thing. I think I'd fall asleep. But you're saying the head should be there.
The head should be there, and it's particularly helpful if you're up to get into a whiplash injury or a rear-end injury. You want to keep that little bump on the back of your head flush with the headrest.
All right. Now, there are all these gadgets that we see, like these Relax the Back stores and all these things. You say there are some of these that aren't worth the money. Back belts, exercise ball seats. Oh, yeah. You see a lot of people sitting on those now. And the footrest, which I asked you about.
Yes.
Why are those lousy?
Oddly enough, the back belt, what they found is that people that wear it are actually injuring themselves more if they don't have back pain because they're using it as a crutch and foregoing proper posture and technique. And so we actually recommend to people that don't have back pain to not wear them.
Okay.
And it's providing more of a mental aspect. So people that have had a prior injury, remember to watch their posture more by wearing the belt.
Okay, and another guy, let me get back to the bed. We said medium firm bed, but you see all these advertisements for these beds with the dials and they go up in the air. Are those things okay?
I actually think that a sleep number bed is actually quite useful to have because you can set it at that medium firm level.
Okay.
You know exactly what that number would be.
All right, we have some exercises here. Let me just say that the bird dog, the glute bridge, and the side plank, and we have Alex, our intern, here to kind of demonstrate for us the bird dog, Josh, how to do the bird.
All right, Alex, so these three exercises are actually proven to strengthen spine-stabilizing muscles in your back. So, Alex, you're going to go ahead and get on those hands and knees like we talked about earlier, and you're going to straighten your left arm and then your right leg. And the things we want to look for here is we don't want the hips to be rotated too much. You want the hips to be nice and straight like she is. We want those extremities to be perfectly parallel to the floor. And she should also not have too much extension in her back. So she should be a little more straight and neutral to the ground as well. So I would amend her slightly to be like that.
Got it. That's the bird dog.
That's the bird dog.
All right. What about the glute bridge?
So the glute bridge, all right, Alex, you can go on your back for this one. So for this one, we want to brace the stomach like you're about to take a punch. So you're going to brace that stomach. And you're going to bring your hips on up toward the ceiling. And you want to be at about a 45-degree angle. So right now, you're a little too high up extended. You want to be more like so. And the keys we want to watch for here, we want to relax the hamstrings. You want to feel your glutes be real tight and squeezed. And you want to feel a little bit of contraction in your low back as well.
All right, and our last one is the side plank.
All right, so the side plank is probably a little more well-known to people, but we're going to make sure we're doing it properly.
Okay.
So side plank, you're going to lay on your side there, Alex, as the name implies. And you're going to be supporting your body weight on your ankles and your forearms. This is a little more advanced, so some people may have to start off on their knees. But what we want to look for here is we don't want the hips to sag too much toward the floor. We want to be about a nice 45-degree angle with the forearm as well. And we want to make sure that the ankles, knees, shoulders, and head are all in a straight line.
Very
that is
nice.
Proper form for the side plank.
I just need you to hold that out for a couple more minutes. And no, Josh, hey, thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
Congratulations on your success. You can find Josh at the Back Safety and Wellness Center in Homewood. Check out backsafetyandwellness.com, and his book is called Secrets to Preventing Back and Neck Pain. Thanks, Josh. Let's send it on back out to Anna.